or go take a break, take a day off. Joseph and Jacob and Mr. Mark, did all you guys get your template that I sent you? Not a problem. Not a problem at all. No, it's fine. I saw the thing pop in a second ago. I haven't expanded it out yet. It looks like you're looking at one of our links from what we call a Broadhead Elite Indicator, which is it was an upgrade tool. And it's basically the same thing. The Broadhead Elite is actually what I'm using here on the NASDAQ. So it's the same tool as far as the calculations are identical. The only thing that's different about the Broadhead Elite is the Broadhead Elite does give you, so from here up, from the targets and stops level up, it's the same tool. The only thing that's different is this tool does give you the ability to set predefined targets and stops on your chart. And you can set them in using an ATR value or using a fixed tick value or using ATR or a fixed tick. And that's the only two difference between those two tools. So whichever one you've got, they work the same as far as the actual signal coming out of the chart wouldn't be any different at all. The only thing that would change is like from this particular signal, this one's a counter trend move. We're back in a chop zone here on the NQ, but from this broadhead, from the close of the doji candle there, blow it up so we can see it big. From the close of the doji candle here, from the close of that bar, it was indicating that this green line was its profit target right there. I use it on here because it's really difficult for me to do the math in my head sometimes when it's quick. So this is showing me that this is 2x the current ATR value at the time of day for that move. That's what that line is demonstrating for me. And the red line above it is showing me that that's 1x. So that's the only real difference between those tools. Yeah, if you wanted to, for printing on pullbacks only, that was what I was showing you earlier. So when you're looking at either of the indicators and you only want to see it, let's say you're using a XYZ moving average, whatever moving average you want to use. If you have, let's say, a 120 period moving average, see if I got a chart here. It's got that on it. I still got your other chart open. So on the chart here, if you wanted just to see arrows that are, let's go from a 120, let's change this out to maybe a 300, just to get a different look on the chart. So if you wanted to just see broadhead signals, and if you want to use, that's not helping at all. So if you wanted to use a broadhead signal, this market is so dead. Well, let's go back to our old faithful here. We'll go to our 600. 600 is going to show us a little different picture. All right, that's going to help looking back. So if I wanted to use a 600 period EMA on this broadhead, I would simply come down here to true. And now I'm going to use 600. So when you see the engage filter section, okay, the engage filter section right there. When you change that to true, it's only going to give you broadhead signals that are in agreement with, this broadhead was in agreement with the direction of the EMA. In other words, the 600 period EMA, the candle was closing below it. Therefore, this became a valid short entry. If we look over here, there was no entry here because it was above the EMA. So it was showing to be above that moving average. This one would have had a valid long for the simple reason that, again, the close the bar above the moving average. So if you're above the moving average, it's going to give you long entries only. If you're below the moving average, it's going to give you short entries only. So that's what you would see there. So it would limit the number of trades you take fairly dramatically. But when you're using things like an ultimate Renko or a Renko bar, again, sometimes this thing, you can see in this particular case, notice it doesn't show any counter trend signals. It's showing all of these signals are only in the direction of this EMA. So if you only want to see these pullback signals in the direction of the moving average, that's what you would set it to. So you'll just turn that filter setting to on, which is here. Again, that's under your broadhead, and engage filter to true. So engage that filter to true right there. That makes sense? Trying not to make it confusing. My head's halfway in a fog today, so I apologize if my head's kind of if I'm in a weird place. But when you've got a market that's like this, it doesn't really matter what you do a whole lot, because this, geez, look at that. Ugh. But it's not really a surprise. Like I say, we came into a chop zone, and it was supposed to be doing that since late last night. And even on here, the Renko bar, it's showing the same junk. Ain't much happening here. There's a lot of back and forth. Just not much happening. This market's just really dead. It's going to liven up quite a bit after tomorrow, I think. But today, yeah, not so much. Hey, Wally. Absolutely. All right, we just came out of the chop zone area on the NQ. We're still in it on the crude here. I got nothing on crude. On the NASDAQ, we came out of the open price line for the chop zone there at 58.89 and a quarter. The market has just pushed up. Lowest risk short entry on the chart was a retest of the prior high. And low risk short entry right there at a retest of the prior swing high at 58.90 and a half. A candle closing above 58.90 and three quarters. Anything closing above that, we are going to be upside down, but we don't have much time here. So again, we're still, the higher time frames are definitely telling us long. The shorter time frame here, just a lot of back and forth action, not a very clean move. 1039 is coming. We're going to be favoring shorts until 1039 unless we close the bar above right there at 58.90 and three quarters. Closing above there, we're going to go up all the way until 1039, potentially then all the way up until 1050. Game on breakout trade. We will get a game on breakout trade at 58.90 and three quarters with the expectation that this is going to be an inverted move. All right, game on breakout trade on the NQ. Jeez. Gobo trade. And there's no denying this uptrend. Game on breakout trade on the NQ. We are inverted. 58.90 and three quarters for the game on breakout. The market is very quickly back up into 58.93 and a quarter. Targets attained. 2.5 point target, 2.5 point stop. Jeez. This was the range of the market. Coming out of the other side of the chop zone. So right there was the range of the market. This one trade would have taken a little bit of heat initially. And there was our market range. So game on breakout trade. Again, short-term moves of the market. Watching for a range to be broken. And we're bracketing the market there. So she broke it. Not getting much follow-through out of it. Initial targets attained. And not much else here. Back down into the open price line now. We are now pulling back into the buy signal. The buy signal is going to be at the close of this bar. So as this market is pulling back down into the close of the bar, let's see where it's going to be. There's power zone buy. Off the power zone buy signal, we stopped at the open price line for the chop zone. By stopping at this open price line, let's watch for the market to give us a push back up. We now have an additional game on breakout trade right there. If the market pulls down into, where's my Hail Mary? It's behind the level right there. If we pull down into 58.86 and three quarters, this will be a Hail Mary long entry. Pull back in the direction of the trend, the trade will have 2 points of risk. So looking for a long entry here at 58.86 and three quarters with 2 points of risk. Hey, Bijan. Do I agree with what you remember? However, several years ago, one of the things that works in the markets. Well, we actually use some cosmic signals. We have four and three. We have the SETI indicator that uses cosmic signals. Daily Cycle Marker uses some. We have Orion uses those. So we actually have four, three. Well, inside of SETI, there's two different indicators in the SETI. So you have the SETI Magneto and the SETI. Drawing a mind blank. So yeah, we have four indicators that actually do that. Now we have five with the solar cycle tool that we're going to demonstrate to all of you guys tomorrow. There's actually five indicators that we have that uses celestial things to do that. Are they useful practically in lower time frames? Oh yeah. Yes, they are, Jacob. They're actually scary how well some of them work. Some of them work so good that we literally, one of our tool sets, the SETI indicators, the gamma and the magneto, it took me a second, the SETI gamma and the SETI magneto, they actually measure, we hack into a NASA satellite, basically, and we take the information off of electromagnetic fields as they're impacting the Earth. And we print that information. We have an algorithm that identifies the information. The algorithm picks it up, changes it over into something that's usable in Ninja so that we can actually see it. And then we plot those on the chart as quickly as we can get there. We actually have about a 3 minute delay. So they're very effective on any chart, 3 minutes and up. Takes about a 3 minute delay on those to get all the information down and effectively put onto the market real time. But yeah, it's really startling how much when you see extra like electromagnetic fields hitting the Earth or a lack thereof, how the markets react when those things occur. Yeah. It only prints on time-based charts. But yeah. Bob, you'll eventually, Jacob, you'll eventually get to meet Swizzle, who's Bob Swearziski. I never can say his last name. There's like too many syllables and not enough vowels. But he's a great guy. He's part of our team. And he actually uses LUR bars exclusively in all the stuff that he does. And I taught him how to trade using those a couple of years ago, and he's taken it to even deeper levels than I ever thought about. He actually uses and does all the same setups that you're seeing that I do here this morning. So where I'm talking about a Hail Mary entry, where I'm talking about game on breakout trades, where I'm talking about all of the trade models that over the course of the next several weeks, you'll hear, you'll learn, you'll become more familiar with. Bob takes every single one of these same setups, but he takes them on his lot on his Renko bar. So instead of a time bar, he does them on the Renko bar, which is fine. And sometimes he doesn't get the same entry I get. Sometimes he gets an entry that I don't get because again, he's basing it off of a Renko bar versus a minute bar, but he's using the same timing signals that I use, exact same signal. And watches for those breakouts to occur and for watches for these pullbacks to occur. We've even developed a completely different methods trading methodology based on some of these things that he runs and moderates a room for. So guys, we're coming down into our Hail Mary long entry. Let's see what we're gonna get. I'm looking for 86 and three quarters. The market had or 87 and three, yeah, 86 and three quarters. Come on, you piece of trash. Got one tick from my entry. I'm sitting here looking at the entry. I thought I was going to get filled there. And the market came down, just got one tick from me. Being one tick from me, this activates the trade. If the trade goes up and touches the profit target now, we will call it a missed trade. I've been sitting here with a limit order waiting at 86 and three quarters. The swing high coming back in the market at 93 and a quarter minus the seven ticks. So our current average true range, we're sitting at 1.8. That's going to be seven ticks. You think 93 and a quarter down into 92 or 92. There's five ticks, six ticks, seven ticks. So we're going to be looking for 91.50. So we're watching for 91.50. If the market touches 91.50 before it pulls back down into 86 and three quarters, then we will call the trade a missed trade. It'll just be over. Otherwise, 86 and three quarters is our current entry level. If we come back and get the fill, which we've been so close to, if we get the fill at 86 and three quarters, that's going to put our risk. Now we're down to a point and a half of risk, actually. So now we're going to be at 84. What is that? 86 and three quarters. It's going to be 85 and three quarters. 85 and a quarter. So volatility is dropping, which means our profit target goes up one and our risk goes up one. So we have a point and a half of risk here. If we can get a fill, we're going to be risking a point and a half to get 86 and three quarters to 92. So risking a point and a half to make five and a half. Not so bad. Bruce, to be honest, I did not have the dome set. I should have had the dome set. I had the dome still set on crude, like a dummy. And I'm not even messing with crude. I should have set it down here at NQ, like I was showing you guys the other day. My fault. I literally, and you know what? I hadn't even thought about using it for the Hail Mary entries. But you're correct. I should be using this for the Hail Marys as well, because that happens often, doesn't it? I think I'll start trying to pull this in when we get a Hail Mary like that. That's a good thought, Bruce. Thank you. Yeah, because there's tons of orders sitting at one tick above our Hail Mary. I mean, that makes perfect sense to move our target up one or our entry up one. So I don't end up with this all the time. That's actually a great idea. Thank you. I need to open up another dome, I guess, and keep one running for the one running for each. All right, Mark. Hey, I'll see you tomorrow, big guy. Yeah, market's kind of slow at the moment. I got nothing going on crude here, so. Yeah, I agree, Jack. Better things to do. Jack's bailing out. Yeah, it's really a dead duck at the moment. All right, we're still looking. We did not get the fill. The market's been here twice, and we did not get the fill. At least I didn't get the fill. Well, guys, there's just not much happening. So we're going to give this market just a little bit longer. It looks like vacation or summertime trading may be coming a little early. See if they're going to pick up any volatility here. All right. Let's see if there's anything new in the world. Yesterday, we were in a car all day, literally. Guys, I'll be back in just a second. Let me grab this call. Be right back. about that, guys. All right. Well, crude. Yeehaw. Are we really doing anything on crude yet? Well, let's take our range of death forward here. There's the opening range of this last chop zone. I got nothing. So crude, the daily still telling us down. 30 minutes still telling us down. 1 minute, nothing here. So the 1 minute on crude is just a dead duck. Back over onto the NQ, we've inverted the zone. So on the NQ, we did not get our Hail Mary. We got the one tick away. We came into the chop zone again. I have no entries in the chop zone. This is the area where I would be looking for something, but again, it was in a chop zone. So I really didn't have anything here. Coming out of the chop zone, what was the swing high and what was the swing low? So bracketing the market as we came out of the chop zone, I could justify this as my swing high. Swing low, well, not a very good one. We were already below the swing low before we came out, and I don't have anything else. So this range has been big. By the swing indicator says our range would be from here to here. So the swing indicator says it'd be bigger. Well, that's a big range. I would be using a level right along in there for the breakout. And again, we did come out just before the swing high. Geez, there's just not a lot here. Game on breakout trade opportunity coming out of this one. And that's the only thing I see at the moment. We are inverse, meaning that the market has put in new lows coming out of the chop zone where it was expected to put in new highs. So we had a 60-40 down to 11-16. So we had a 40% chance it would move down, 60% chance it would move up, coming in off of the same time of day. And it's chosen a downward direction this time. So not much to see here. We're going to come out of this one 11-16. We're going to reset the signal. We have a messy area again coming into 11-25. As we're coming into 11-25 today, 11-27 actually, off of 11-27, this will be the time of day that we are expecting the longest duration trend move of the morning. So we haven't had a whole lot of that for the day. Let's see what we're going to get here coming out of 11-25. And again, I have nothing on crude. So crude just kind of at the moment. Yeah, we should probably have a meeting, Jacob, and we can go over all that kind of stuff. All right, power zone cell signal. We only have 2 minutes or three. We're coming into the chop zone on the NQ. We are still within three ticks of where we started the range on crude hours and hours and hours ago. So crude not doing anything here. Yeah, just send me an email. We'll figure out a time when we can get together for an hour and meet. All right, we're in the chop zone. Jeez, ugly area here. So keep a close eye out. We're not going to come out of this until 11:27, 11:28. Coming out of 11:27:28, I'm looking for a breakout trade. We're going to be watching for that push up from there. What a boring day in the markets. Boring. All right. For those of you guys following along with the Vegas trade on the NQ, we are now below the trend stalker level again. So we had our first long entry way back over this morning. So we had the long entry that came into the market at 9 o'clock. We have until 12 o'clock for this trade. So this trade has an entry option until 12. Keep an eye out for this one. For those of you who have been around for a while and you've been keeping an eye out for this trade with me, keep an eye out for these areas. I'm seeing these more and more, and I did not do an initial test for these. This is a Hail Mary entry using the same premise for direction. And I'm seeing these happen a lot. I don't really know if I would handle the start targets and stops the same way as I would a regular Hail Mary. In most of the instances where I've seen this occur, the targets and stops go well above. So I think I would probably be leaning toward a full retest of a swing high on this particular premise. Again, we're using a 60-minute power zone. So again, I want you guys to keep an eye out there with me. I will eventually get around doing some testing on this one. I've got a caseload and a half right now we're working on at the moment, but just something to keep an eye out for. So for those of you folks watching this 3-minute chart with me, keep an eye out for when this market makes this pullback. And it's a Hail Mary entry, but I don't know, again, I don't think I would use all this exact same Hail Mary rules. I would probably look for a retest of the full swing high. That has been the bigger case lately. So keep an eye out for that. All that being said, the market is now pulled back down. We are below the trend stalker level again. So when we clips below here, we now have a reset of the signal, which means if the market closes above 58.8750 before 12 o'clock, we would have an additional long entry on the NASDAQ. So our NQ 3-minute would have an additional long if we close above 58.8750 before 10 o'clock. If we closed it right now, that would be a 5-point. Yeah, if we closed it right now, it would be a 5-point risk trade looking for a 10-point profit target. So if we close it out right now, that's what we'd be. We'd be a 5 and a 10. So, yeah. So keep an eye out. We'd be looking for a 10-point target if we got that fill before 12 o'clock at 58.87.5, which would obviously put us up here into a 97.5, and we'd be risking 5 points off of that one. For 87.5, that'd be back down into 82.5. So if we get the fill before 12 o'clock, watch for 58.87.5 on the NQ. All right, coming out of the chop zone at the close of the next bar, crude would have to speed up to stop. It's such a dead market at the moment. That's been our whole morning right there. Just nothing here. Thought we had some excitement there for a minute, but yeah, no. I have nothing on crude today. As we're coming out of this chop zone in about a minute, can we identify a prior swing low? Bracket the market. Well, we actually have a prior swing high coming into the market right there. Swing low would, I would say, be here. So this would be our bracket of the market. That means we're going to be looking for a breakout trade, a game on, or a gobo trade. So watch for a game on breakout trade, and let's see if this market's going to be able to punch. If we come, we're expecting to punch the highs. If we clip above 58.85.25, 2.5-point profit target, 2.5-point stop if we eclipse that number. If we break out below the bottom, well, watch for a move out the bottom in the same way. 2.5-point target, 2.5-point stop. Premise of the trade is the time of day that we should start trending again, and we're looking for a breakout of the range at the time of day the trend should start. So let's see what's going to happen here in the next minute or two. A lot of little A Stokes signals in there too. Look at that, back and forth. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of those things in a 8-minute range. Yeesh. No mas. No mas. All right, we're out of the chop zone on the NQ. Let's see where the market's going to go. Watch for a gobo trade. Game on breakout. We've opened our first bar below the open price line. So the open price line coming in right now on the NQ here at 58.79 and a half. We are expecting to see the underlying trend from 58.79 and a half push up into 11.48. That's really not a bad little run. All right, crude finally making a little bit of movement here. I say a little bit. If we look at it in a grand scheme of things, not really. Crude, we've been stuck most of the morning with this open price line hanging out right there. We've got an OPL 47.30 from a chop zone. We have an open price line at 47.09 from a power zone. And it's just really had a hard time here. So nothing much going on trend-wise on crude for the day. Again, not expecting it to be until 1:30 this afternoon. So 1:30 this afternoon, if you're trading on the NQ or on the crude over here, that's the time we're going to be looking for that major move to start. So keep an eye out for 1:30 this afternoon. Tell you what, I'm grabbed a little long here on the NQ only because it had very low risk. It's only about 2 points of risk in this little trade, actually 2.5. But I've grabbed a little long on it, expecting to see the market give me a push back up. And I'm going to see if I can get anything off of this. I'll go flat if I get up back into the moving average. I want to see the market give me a push back up into 84, 58, 84, and then beyond. So I'm hanging on to a long on the crude right now. I tried to get a second fill. It only filled one of my positions at 80. So still very dead market right now. I may come back and fill the other one. Come on. Sounds like watching paint dry. There we go. All right. So I'm not going to lose any cash on the trade. Grabbed the long right there, 58.80, just above the open price line with the expectation it may come up and break out the high. Going to go to a free position over on this trade. I'm up 2.75 points. Said earlier, if I tapped it, there we go. So I grabbed a quick two off of it. So $2 off the NQ there. And I said if we hit the moving average, I was going to dump it. And I did. So dumped it right there at the MA. So nice little 2.25 point move on the way up. So again, the premise here, when I saw the first candle close above the open price line out of that chop zone, that's the direction it should move. I had a fairly limited risk because the market, again, had a fairly nice little swing low here and we were opening close to it. So I took the direction of the power zones expected to move and I just took it up to the MA. So a little discretionary trade there. Grabbing, a little scalp off of that one today, no question. All right, guys and gals, I'm going to bail out of here for the morning. Thank you, everybody, for being here with me. I appreciate you being here. I'm sorry if we've just had a dead duck of a market. So we've had a few opportunities on the NQ, not anything on the crude. That'll change after tomorrow. Thursday, we'll probably be right back to snuff again. So we'll see what the markets give us. Some days, this is the first one of these days I can remember we've had in months and months and months. So We'll see what happens. Thanks again, everybody. I appreciate you being here with us. I'll look forward to seeing you back on Thursday. Mark will be with you tomorrow, and then we'll pick it up again. Same Flux channel, same Flux time. Have a wonderful day.